West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada, none of this. Six gunning this, brother running this. Buffalo soldier, look, it's like I told you. Any damsel that's in distress, be out of that.
Episode 116, wow. Dude, we're flying fucking in, dude. We're flying in. We got the motherfucking Gerbys,
we got
dude.
Gerbys.
Gerbys on the track.
How do you get this fucking thing out now?
Out of your, yeah, Gerbys. Shane Seltzer stuck in Gerbys QZ.
Gerbys texted us before it and said he was going to bring over seltzers, which also I think the funny part was in parentheses, he listed the flavors.
True that.
That's like, actually,
that was an important
want?
Text because I'm Thank like, you. I'm a bit of a seltzer snob.
Really?
I'm all Spindrift. Spindrift's when they just take fruit and squeeze it in the can, end of discussion. You got, this is like the, you know, when they tinker around with the...
Yeah, no, my
This
text,
is like diet soda. We're just like moms from the 90s getting tricked into drinking diet soda again. We're like, oh no, they're just fucking natural flavors. It's yeah, we're drinking fucking Diet Coke.
I don't think there's any sugar in there.
It's not. It's a flavoring. Oh. Apparently the Diet Coke fucked a bunch of moms up.
Okay.
Do you know any moms that like chug that shit?
Yeah.
I knew moms who would blow through a case of Diet Pepsi a week. Easy.
My mom drank Diet...
Did
diet,
she?
Diet Coke.
Did she smoke cigarettes as well?
No. She just had diabetes.
A lot of cigarette smoke. Really?
Yeah. She's diabetic. Not a fat kind.
She caught it. She, type uno?
Yeah.
What?
Just real deal.
She's type 1?
Diabetes.
Damn.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. My mom's going to fucking die, dude.
I thought she was being vain.
Nah.
I thought she was being vain about her figure.
Nah. She's, yeah, she's not fat.
So that
she's
was like
got
a
regular old diabetes.
That was definitely a cheat code of like some like old moms who couldn't give it up. You know what I mean? Hit 40s and they're like weren't as hot as they used to be. Sip a couple diets, thinking they're going to get it back. It's like breast cancer.
It's gone.
Yeah.
Oh, you got breast cancer now.
Well, that's what happens. Yeah.
Really,
that Diet Coke shit apparently gives people breast cancer. It's fucked up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Can't be hot forever.
Yeah. Speaking of hot.
Woo, Gerby, baby.
Gerb dog sliding in. You look good, man.
Thank you.
Continue to look fantastic.
Is that right? What's going on? Yeah, thank you.
You're on roids, bro?
What's it?
You're on roids?
No, I'm not on roids.
Are you blood
doping? It was, my mom came over for lunch the other day, and she said...
What'd she say?
No, I was in a t-shirt.
Oh, you were just like a taking care of business type t-shirt?
I was in a t-shirt, but it's a...
Damn, are you flexing on your mom?
No, it's the opposite of
what
that.
What was that movie where Tom Cruise comes out in like
risky
a shirt?
Risky Business.
Yeah, was that...
Did
were you
slide
like,
in?
Were you risky business in?
No, I didn't risky business
but
anywhere.
So you're just in a tee, like a tee in khakis, like a 1950s dad?
Yes.
Damn,
you know, a tee and some Adidas track pants.
High-waisted khakis,
whoa.
Were you like a cholo?
No, so Adidas track pants, slim Adidas track pants, right?
So you got a little bulge going now.
Nah.
It's not about the penis. It has nothing to do with the penis. Now, hang on. Let me give you a little backstory. The last time I was here, I think, was when you complimented my body, and that did a lot. Mm. So then I weighed myself. Yes, because
nice.
You know how you're like, you're in a workout routine and somebody compliments your body, you're like, I'll redouble my
efforts.
Sure,
for sure.
Of course.
So I weighed myself, and I had lost a little weight. So the problem is I wasn't eating any carbs, really.
Yeah. Mm.
And so then I just started upping the carb intake.
Carb cycling.
Yes. So for about a month now, I've been, you know, really putting the carbs down.
Damn.
And so then my mom comes over and I'm in a t-shirt and then like we're just talking and then she goes, so you still working out? And I was just like, am I still working out?
Yeah, mom.
It,
obviously. You should have fucked her up.
I thought she was going to say, she was like, damn, you look fucking
swole.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
No, that's what I was expecting too.
Yeah.
And the same thing happens when I go to the doctor every time. She's like, so do you work out? And this is every 6 months. And I've even like joked with her. I was like, put a note in your file to be like, hey, you're looking great. You're clearly working out. Because it should show, but it doesn't. And the reason it doesn't is I honestly have extremely narrow shoulders. If you saw me with my top off, clothes
my
just...
top off?
My shirt off.
Convertible?
If you saw me with my shirt off, you'd say, jeez Louise, those are some narrow shoulders.
Yeah,
that's a nice top. You have a nice top
Thank
on
you,
right
this
now.
Because it has to... Well, fuck off, whatever. But it's a whole thing.
Okay.
And then...
Do you do any delts? You like hit in the rows?
Of course I do. Yes. Sorry for
damn,
yelling at
you. Of course,
you,
bro. Shut the fuck up, man. Obviously he does, dude. He's roided out. He's roided
I
out.
I told you he's on
Gerbys
roids.
Is on roids.
No, no, no. I will definitely be sending you a photo.
Will you do some delts?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Please send us a video of you doing a
delt
workout.
Are you doing some bent over rows?
Yeah.
What else?
Where?
In this workout room.
What workout
like a gym?
Room?
Yeah, my house.
Okay, you're in your house.
Yeah. I just have some mats down and then a pull-up bar and some... And those Bowflex
adjustable
dumbbells. They're fantastic.
Wait, so what do you, I mean, you're talking about rows, you're talking about pull it. What are you doing for the shoulders?
For the shoulders?
Yeah.
So I watched this guy, Jeff Cavalieri, who is on YouTube. He's got Athlean X. He's fantastic.
Okay.
And so I just do different cycles of what he would suggest.
What's he do? What's his shoulders look like?
They look fantastic. I don't know.
He's got like the Ninja Turtle muscles going on?
Definitely.
Whew, nice. Like that.
Damn. But, so what are you getting swole for? Just eat pussy?
Well, I think just like general confidence, I suppose.
Nice.
But that was so... Given that I have...
Anytime people work out, I get mad at them.
Why?
Because I don't. So I'm like, what, are you gay?
Really? You don't like that?
I don't like people working out.
What happened to your keto diet?
It comes and goes. Mm-hmm. It's still... I'm still losing weight, which is weird.
Okay.
Floating in and out of ketosis.
Yeah, just... like last night, I had beer.
Yeah.
So...
You're out.
So I'm out.
Out of ketosis.
Today, I had potatoes.
You can have like two Michelob Ultras and stay in ketosis.
Matt, if I have two Michelobs... Parties. The train's already rolling. The train is downhill, dude. I'm out of control. The brakes are off.
True that. Yeah. You got to start butt chugging.
I'll butt chug.
Yeah, start butt chugging, dude. Yeah, or just start fucking take Xannies, dude.
Fuck yeah.
Take like three Xannies instead of drinking.
Yeah, just take like fall three asleep bar. Everywhere.
You just black out and steal everybody's shit and go home.
Yeah, I got fucked up that one time off vodka. Vodka sodas. Now I can't drink them.
True that.
I don't want them. Vodka sucks.
I love it.
When you hit me with that plan of like, I'm just going to drink vodka, I was like, dude,
yeah,
that's
got,
not the
I
move.
I got hammered. Of course. I had an empty stomach because I wasn't eating. And I threw up.
Yeah,
the next
dude.
Day, I puked the next morning, which I never do.
Yeah, you're not a big puker. Yeah, no. When you're in ketosis and you put some vodka in the system,
I got fucking wrecked.
I don't think ketosis is made for like vodka
dude,
or something.
Dude, still getting fucking blacked out.
Dude, I'm still on my plant-based bullshit, dude. I thought I was going to get off. I thought the meat was going to be my motivator doing my little hunter-gatherer diet.
Yeah.
I don't even really want it.
You're just a gatherer.
I'm just a gatherer, bro. I'm just a fucking...
Straight gav. Dude.
I just tranced like a 1BC lady, dude. It's the
That's
weirdest,
what you identify
it's
as
the weirdest
now.
Fucking thing.
Just a Cro-Magnon
I'm just
woman.
A Cro-Magnon. Dude, it's the weirdest fucking thing.
Yeah.
I was like so excited to eat meat again. I started eating it and I'm like, meh.
Yeah, it's not worth it, huh?
It's weird. It's bizarre. I mean, I'll probably get off of it. I'll probably get back to on the meat wagon, but dude, it's fantastic. And no one wants to hear it. I'm like, I was telling Sydney the other day, I'm like, dude, I'm telling you, man, I eat like primarily plants. And he's like, I do this thing where like I eat like my body's. I'm like, yeah, okay. But like, trust me, there's like hard science behind this, bro.
Yeah.
And I used to say the same thing. I'm like, I just eat what I need. And it was apparently like fucking bread and potatoes and shit all the time.
Did you got a nice palate or like a canvas? You got a nice starting body structure.
A mesomorph?
Yes. I'm an For ecto. Sure. So I have to put the meat.
You have to. You got to. Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
It's a fucking nightmare.
Is it? A
it's not.
He's vegan.
No,
well,
no.
Your chances of getting fat are less.
You got all dungarees on right now.
I
full denim, dude.
So
no, what Ecto's got to watch out
shirt?
For?
This was from H&M like 3 years.
You
ago.
Got that top from H&M?
Yeah.
Looks like he wrestled a cowboy and took it off his back.
What I'm wearing is just a denim buckle. Sure, I do feel slightly stupid in it.
Yeah,
but
why the fuck are you dressed like that?
No, you're monochrome.
Well, here's,
dude.
Okay, here's why I'm dressing like that. First
We're
of,
monochrome.
First of all,
He's
I can't
not.
Wear a single fucking sure. thing around him. I've never worn a thing.
Anything but sweats is taboo around here.
Yeah.
Yeah, Matt's in a full green sweatsuit right now. And I'm like, yo, that's fucking sick. I'm in an all black sweatsuit right now.
He makes sick. Me feel so stupid
You're
all the
time.
You're
in a fucking denim button down.
You look stupid. Then the one time, the last time I did comedy, I took a seat on a stool because of lighting issues.
Yeah,
he don't fucking sit on a stool and don't wear suits.
All
right, I'm all leaving.
He wore a suit and sat on the stool.
No, I didn't.
And
no,
then
kneeled. Those were separate incidences.
And then he crouched down next
yeah,
to the stool.
Yeah, because it was just... anyway, the I
You
wonder,
crushed
wait, what's
that
up,
night,
So what's up, with yeah. that, what's up with that gear?
Well, what I wanted to tell you guys was that... So the way my... Again, the body... As my chest and my front... So now imagine me from the side. And
I just rotated you one of those creative players.
Held R1.
My chest and my back are starting to poof out a little
okay.
bit. And I'm working on my shoulder and my scapular wing.
Nice.
But
yeah, I worked that scapular wing.
Yeah, it's really terrible looking. Like you could see,
that's, anyway. What, that's that thing where you pinch and you have like the two big
yeah, like your
raptor
your
bones,
chicken wings, yeah, Ooh. Sticking out of the back. So, but my shoulders are still narrow. So what happens with t-shirts is they start to get like stretch marks around like my
your pecs.
Right. Yeah. Wow. My pecs. And then, but the sleeves are long. So I Googled it and it was like, I was like,
you got to put a pack of cigarettes in them and roll them up.
The last time I tried to roll up my sleeves, O'Connor was like, don't do that. And then I explained the whole thing.
Why does everyone hate on you, bro?
I can't wear a single thing around me.
Yeah, well, stop trying to be fashionable.
No, you got to start rolling up your sleeves like a young Jew Dean.
But I don't maximize my body. You know? It's like, why am I eating all this meat and doing delts if I can't, you know?
You got to roll your sleeves up. Fuck that, dude.
That's what I'm going to do.
Honestly, cut them off.
No, I'm rolling them up.
No, do a half cut.
If you went sleeveless denim right now, I'd be all about it.
I'd be willing to cut the sleeves off of this shirt right now.
You should start rocking like a quarter cut. Get like a nice quarter sleeve.
Anyway, so I Google, you know, men's shirts with very short sleeves.
Men's tops.
Men's t-shirts with very short sleeves. And the Google result is like
a gay porn.
And then if you Google that, you'll get the top result is from bodybuilding.com.
Yeah,
which
the top
is
result is Grindr. For sure. It's just like, all right, well, you're gay.
And so
men in short sleeves.
So then the top thing is like a post from 2012. And somebody's like asking what I'm asking. How do you get those very short sleeves? And like the first response is, I'm just kind of quoting here. It's like, are you going to be one of those faggots that buys women's shirts? You know, blah, blah, blah. So then when I read that, I was like, oh, that's the piece of information I was looking for. Dude, I ordered
it's a good
women's
idea.
Shirts. Yeah.
Yeah. Wear
you ordered
fucking,
women's
you
shirts?
Jack in a woman's shirt?
Yeah. Yeah. No.
Little spaghetti shirt. Spaghetti
no, you don't look jacked. You look very, very weird. It was a silly looking shirt. It went right in the trash.
Well, that's called a baby doll tee.
Okay.
Women's small t-shirts are called, I think, like baby doll tees, and they come up to like their shoulders.
Yes.
They come up to their little shoulders. And
Doll tee, that's what I'll have to Google.
That's what you got
to
Google.
They should have it for
or you should just get a tube top, bro.
Yeah, rock a tube top.
Just bust out of that thing, dude. See what your mom has to say after that.
Yeah.
Your
tell
striations,
that bitch mom
dude.
That you're fucking jacked, dude. Yeah, next time you go over for dinner, get a fucking crop top.
It did. It ruined
a fucking
lunch.
Tube top and just walk in.
You should just fucking dress and drag and go home.
Yeah, you just sweat. Just
I'd be an incredibly hot woman.
Yeah, dude.
No, my God.
I'm all legs. I got narrow shoulders.
You would be
horrendous.
Nah, Gerbs would be fucking hot, dude. Gerbs would look like the one lady from Sex and the City who like moves outside of Brooklyn. You know what I'm talking about?
Which one? The redhead. Yeah, the redhead. That's what I was thinking.
I don't think you have any idea.
No, that's hot, bro.
6 foot.
That's fuck. I forget her name.
I forget.
It's not Samantha.
It's not Samantha. Samantha's a blonde
a hot slut.
Yeah, she's a blonde slut.
Yeah, dude. Samantha was a slut, dude.
Carrie was a bit of a slut too.
They were all
sluts.
They were all sluts.
But Carrie was fucking a bunch of Mr. Big, dude.
Yeah.
That was her big thing.
Carrie was the main character.
Yep.
Samantha was the hot slut. Charlotte was my go-to.
Oh,
Charlotte was that prim and proper fucking good girl, dude. That's a Central PA girl, dude.
She was a good girl.
Just a good down home mediocre slut. She wasn't even a slut.
True that. That show, I think, ruined a fucking generation of women.
Yeah.
Like, I think it fucked them up.
Let's get mimosas and fuck dudes every day. It's like, that's a nightmare. You're gonna get AIDS.
Well, there was a girl who apparently tried to, like, not sue Sex and the City, but, like,
she
modeled her life. She, like, literally SJP'd, went to New York, became, like, a sex blogger or something. And like did this for like held up like a fake Sarah Jessica Parker identity, and then like started a blog about how like harmful it was to her, and how like you can't base your life off Sex and the City, and how like it fucked her up. How she was like looking for Mr. Biggs and stuff, dude. Like that's crazy.
Yeah,
and I think reality TV is doing the same thing to him.
Yeah,
it's crushing him.
Yeah, we talked about that a little.
We talked about the internet, right?
Instagram just destroying,
ruining them. We got into that last week about relational aggression.
Yeah,
that's a girl stuff.
How girls
are
mean.
That?
What do you think about that?
No, I listen to that. I think that's true. But I have that sort of thing. I've been off Instagram and Twitter for the most part.
I thought you were relationally aggressive.
What?
I thought you were saying you're relationally aggressive. I was like, that's fucking sick. Dude.
No, Gerby's is very...
Very non-relationally aggressive.
Very nice.
So you're off the social media.
Yeah, because it was... But it was doing the same sort of like... That same sort of thing you were talking about where you'd see, you know, somebody out doing something.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm just like... I don't know. It was having a negative impact, I think.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. I think that's the consensus.
I see it. Well, yeah, mine is I just look at it and I'm like, what a bunch. When I see like four of those like pictures of words in a row of like Monday, I told my boss, you know what I'm saying? When someone's like like snapshots, words, but like on like a purple background.
Oh yeah.
I'll see like four of those in a row and I'm like, God, what the fuck? And I'm just like, what a bunch of fucking idiots. Then I'm like, why the fuck am I looking at this? I'm a fucking loser. And I did like, just turn it off.
And also everybody's like, my life's a mess.
Yeah, that's a...
everybody's fucking Instagram. It's like me. And it's like a drunk piece of shit.
Yeah.
It's like, that's me today.
I think
I'm depressed. It's like, all right.
I think people have a... we have like a weird yearning for childhood that I don't think any other generation has had so far. Like 30-year-olds being like, Ninja Turtle movie sucked. It's like, bro, fucking 30. Like, of course it did. But yeah, I'm telling you, it's like a... Even... The fact now that people ironically refer to themselves being an adult is blows my fucking mind.
That is interesting, yeah.
That's weird. Like, I'm adulting?
I'm adulting. Yeah. Like, we bought our first house. I don't know what we're doing, but it's like, just, fuck, it's like running a place, bro. It's not a big deal. It's, you have to, like, it's almost like you have to acknowledge the fact that you're an adult in a way where you're like, I'm not really an adult. It's like, what the fuck, dude? We're all losing it, dude.
Yeah, we suck.
Yeah. We got to take it back to the fucking just short sleeves. Denim on denim, dude.
Denim on denim.
Well, you should just prepare yourself for the spring and summer weather. I will be rolling up my sleeves because I do have a... Yes,
dude. All right, so fuck yeah. This is why I hate when you are fashionable.
Why?
Because he's done it before.
So what?
And it fucking sucked.
What? Yo, hold on.
What did I do before?
You've tried to wear cool stuff in the past.
Like the suit?
Suit? Whatever. I'm not talking about the suit. I'm talking about younger days when you were dressed like a fucking magician.
When I would wear the shirt and tie?
That was a horrible decision.
Oh, you're talking about pickup artist garb.
Pickup artist garb.
Anyone like could fall into that.
Yeah, but I don't want to see him fall back into that. Because the shit you're wearing now that you think is cool, 5 years you're going to be like, what the fuck? I looked like a dickhead.
Nah.
All right.
I don't think this is necessarily cool. I just look good.
You have some regular gear on right now.
Right.
Yeah, you look good.
But a regular Joe.
Let's really come to a consensus about the sleeve rolling because
you're going to roll your sleeves?
Why not, dude? Show them off.
I do want to roll my sleeves. Yeah.
Right, if you want to, do it.
But am I going to look like
don't
a dickhead?
Fucking do it around?
Hell no, dude. Yo, first rule. First rule of rolling up your sleeves, dude. No apologies.
Yeah.
If you're going to roll your fucking sleeves, you roll your fucking sleeves up. Yeah, dude. No one asked permission to roll up their sleeves, bro.
I don't have the personality to sustain any sort of conflict around my sleeve rolling.
Damn, I'm so excited for you to very defeatedly roll your sleeves down.
No, what I'm going to end up doing is buying a sewing machine and then just sewing my sleeves at the proper length.
Take it to the... No, I was actually thinking about that. Take it to like a corner laundromat and just fucking scold one of those old ladies. And
make the Chinese do it.
Yeah, sewing it for you.
Okay.
They fucking love sewing shit.
Yeah, dude.
They're all, oh, dude. I was
go to the thing and be like, have, like, sew my thing and they can give me a woman while I wait.
I went to the Gold Standard cafe before this. Me and Claire went out to breakfast. Well, breakfast. And there's a Japanese lady working and she didn't know whose order it was. And I could tell she didn't want to make an announcement because her English sucked.
So I was just watching her.
She was holding this Eggs Benedict. And she didn't want to make the announcement. But eventually she had to be like, did anyone order Eggs of Benedict? And Claire looked at me and was like, don't fucking say anything. And I was just like... She's like, Eggs of Benedict?
Well, the shame must have been so heavy at that point.
Yeah, well, I could... Because I watched her the whole way. She made the announcement like from our table. She was standing like right next to me. And I saw her like... Like hesitate to make the announcement, and I was like, "Yes, dude," because she was trying so hard to just find the person.
Oh, she probably blushed. And was like, and her dad was in the back with like a wife beater with khakis pulled up to his nipples, like, "Oh, dude, what about his son? Always so forgetful."
It's pretty great because it's by Penn's campus, so it's a bunch of Chinese running around, dude. Japanese, mostly Japanese.
Fuck.
And they were very fucking dishonored about the fucking Eggs of Benedict.
Dude, you got. I know just in Asian culture, if you have like a mysterious Eggs Benedict, dude, you just trash him. Be like, I need another Eggs Benedict.
Eggs of Benedict. Yeah, it was wonderful.
Kiku-san, always so forgetful.
It was great, just like, especially because immediately Claire looked at me and was like, don't. Because she fucking knew I wanted to be like, that was me. No, what? Like, I wanted to talk to this lady. Oh, my God. Get her fucking
you should make right here, talk. Let her sit him down. And when someone's like, where's Meg's Benedict? She would have been like, it's like, sorry, is it not your Egg Benedict?
I'd be like, no, this is mine.
She's like, okay, sorry.
Yeah, dude, Asians are the shit.
Oh, they're the best.
I support them. I don't want people to think that we're being racist.
I don't think
it's very good. Supportive.
It's hilarious, dude.
Japanese are the shit.
Dude, I've
bad boys for a while, but now they cleaned their act up.
They did. Well, I mean, they were minding their own business, and they were.
No, they were not.
Yeah, they were on their island, fucking walking around forever. They were walking around like Power Rangers for a while on their island, just Literally, it was like controlling the rice supply.
Yeah,
they would like. They'd be like, "You got to make 50 bushels of rice for me," and you know, I'd wear a fucking. I'd walk around like a weird totem pole or transformer.
Dude, did you ever
they
watch
had to
that?
Figure it out.
Did you ever watch that History of Japan thing on YouTube?
What?
It's fucking sick. This guy just goes through the entire history of Japan in like a 15-minute YouTube video.
Apparently someone's trying to tell me that they made up samurai culture. Like it wasn't as crazy as they said, and it was a propaganda by the Japanese government to instill like a sense of warriorness in people. They had a feudal system, but like all the rituals and shit, someone said they made that shit up.
I don't know. I think they literally had like a shogun and like a military empire. Emperor.
Yeah, they had the... They
not
had
the emperor. Like a samurai emperor was like... We're the emperor.
They had that. But apparently there was parts of the culture. Someone was telling me Carlin talked about it.
Oh, really?
How there's like a lot of the folklore around the samurai.
Well, if Carlin said it, I believe it.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Well, he said
I wasn't sure where you're getting this.
I believe it all. I love samurai stuff.
Yeah, samurai.
But that's a sick fucking trick, dude.
Yeah.
To tell people, like, and then if you are dishonorable, you stab yourself in the stomachs.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that shit was probably a little fabricated.
Yeah, that's what they're saying. They're like, people didn't do shit like that. It was just a feudal society.
Yeah, I've always thought that. It's like, that's a tough fucking... It's like, yeah, we lost the battle. Now the general's going to cut his guts out.
Yeah, dude.
It's like, dude.
I mean, you would think that would translate... I don't know what the suicide rate is like that in Japan. Who kills themselves more?
I think the Japanese are pretty high up on the suicide
scale. Do they really?
Yeah, they do it a lot. They have that forest where fucking...
True that.
That vlogger
the sui zone.
Found that dude, yeah, up in the fucking suicide forest.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
What do you think of that, Gerbs?
What, the blogger?
Yeah, Logan Paul or Logan
Paul? I
didn't
watch the video.
It's great.
It's so
fucking funny.
It's just fucking...
Dude, it's
is
him.
Is he attempting to be funny or is
yeah,
it just...
Yeah, he's a huge fucking dildo and he's... First off, he's running around Japan throwing like stuffed Pokeballs at Japanese people.
Stop.
He's dressed like a Pikachu, running around harassing people. Like he's the biggest
so
dickhead
he's fitting
on earth.
In.
Yeah, he's literally the biggest fucking
so everyone loves
dickhead
him.
On earth.
Damn.
And then
he was throwing Pokeballs at people.
Yeah, he was throwing Pokeballs at like Japanese Tokyo partners.
Did
dude.
He catch anyone?
Literal Tokyo partners standing there.
What
like,
did they do? Did they buck out of the
just
ball?
Look at him and be like,
did they buck the out of the ball?
Yeah, they rattled. The ball shook a couple times.
The Tokyo out. Partner has escaped.
Tokyo partner is tough to catch.
Oh fuck yeah,
that's
dude.
A final form.
I wouldn't want to start a Poke Battle Ball or Pokeball battle with a partner? Tokyo partner, dude. They probably have the latest shit.
You get fucking laid out, dude.
Yeah.
So he's fucking with all these people, and then he's like, "I hear there's a suicide forest. Let's go check it out." And of course, there's a partner hung himself.
Jesus.
So he finds a partner, and they're like, "Look at this fucking dead body! Whoa." I've never seen a dead body in my life. This is crazy.
What?
Yeah. Some fucking partner was...
This had to have been a long time ago.
When this happened?
Yeah.
Last year?
Oh, it was just last year?
Yeah.
Damn. Just, how's this guy's fan base looking?
He took a slight hit, but he's fine. His fan base is like 12-year-olds.
They're like, whoa.
Yeah. They're like, he's hilarious. That's then he started crazy. Making rap videos.
The last
do yourself
I
a favor and watch yeah. Logan and Jake Paul made rap videos. Instagram stars started making rap videos, and they are fucking crazy.
Well, there's a subculture for YouTube that's just for fucking morons.
Yeah.
Like, that guy's in like hard moron terrain
complete
of YouTube.
Moron. And that's another like a perfect example of people being like, yeah, but he's rich. Must be doing something right. It's like, no, he's a fucking retard.
Yeah.
That guy sucks.
Yeah.
And I hate when people are like, yeah, they're rich doing something. You're just jealous. It's like, no.
Yeah, I wouldn't
yeah,
switch.
They're rich. Okay. The guy sucks.
Yeah.
That's true.
It's always
that
bothered me.
That is, people will defend the everyone always does the thing with the Kardashians. We're like, she's actually a smart businesswoman.
Yeah, it's like, no, she's not. She made a sex tape, has a fat ass. Now she's married to a fucking black Republican.
I mean, kind of genius.
True. I mean, I knew I was going to sweat you on that one.
people always say that. Well, you're doing the same thing. Like, she's rich. You're just jealous. And it's like, all right. Honestly, though, how much would you take? How much would it cost for you to fuck Ray J?
Me? Mm-hmm. I saw Ray J earlier this year.
What?
Yeah, ran into him up at Sirius.
Talking
Sirius
about his XM. Root?
I saw him. And
like, nice root, bro.
It was a thick fucking root, dude. Like,
nice root, bro.
No, he had a fucking posse, though. There was like 50 dudes up there.
Who's rolling with Ray J?
Ray J's got a thick fucking root and a thick squad, dude.
Dude, you
got
to get through his squad to get to his root?
Impossible. You can't get to his root. You gotta battle like 12 black dudes to get a look at the root.
You gotta get through the ravine, dude. All the roots probably cross around them.
What do you think of that, Gerbs? Checking your phone.
I just got a text. I didn't know if my dad was coming today or not. And
him on the cast.
Yeah, tell your dad to get in here. Your dad hates me.
What? Does he really?
Yeah, remember when I tried to take a shit and he was like, no?
Yeah, yeah.
He denied you a shit? He denied you a shit?
This was insane. And Gerby stands behind him. Whose house were you in? We were at the fucking tire shop. We were filming tires, etc. His dad comes in. There's an office. So the only bathroom is in the public bathroom.
Yeah.
Is in the lobby where every single person was.
And we're filming.
That we were filming. So I can't take a shit in there.
Where are you filming? Oh, wait, it's closed while you're filming?
Yeah.
Yeah, the shop's closed. But
and he wouldn't let you shit.
So I go upstairs.
There's
and he's
an upstairs
like,
office.
We try to go to the executive suite.
Another toilet. And
which is what everyone was using, except his dad wasn't there. So his dad was there. When I was up there, and he's like, what are you doing? I was like, I was just going to go to the bathroom. And he was like, there's one downstairs. And I was like, yeah, I mean, more privacy. And he was like, what do you mean? I was like, I got to fucking spell it out. I'm going to take a shit. And O'Connor was in another room and heard it and walked out and was like, that was crazy. Like, it was crazy.
Damn.
Your dad got me, dude.
I think
Gerby defended it. Gerby was like, well,
let's hear the defense.
No, I'm not defending what my dad did. There's no defense.
He shut down a dump, dude.
The last time I was there, I went upstairs to take a shit, and Gerby was like, I'll clean it then. Yeah, go ahead. It's like, what?
Because he is letting us
spray shit everywhere and not clean it?
Look, it's insane, but I can't. The drama, I mean, he is just as stubborn as you could be. So if you're like, I'm going to go shit in this thing, and he's like, if he shits in this, then I'm not having anybody here, then it's like, well, what do I do? So it's just like.
He threatened to shut down production.
I was joking with him. I was joking with him before the second one. I was like, and everybody, just so you know, is going to shit in your private bathroom. He's like, Steven, I'll shove the... And it was a whole thing. So I was like, you gotta fucking relax because I'll just clean it. I don't fucking care. It's like...
I'm on your dad's side.
I mean, if you put it that way...
Here's where I'm on your dad's side from. Your dad's been cleaning up fucking, like, low-level mechanic dumps.
Nah, you should see the mechanic's dumps.
That's what I'm saying.
No, that bathroom is a fucking
That's what I'm
dungeon.
Saying, dude. You're, when a Jiffy Lube mechanic takes a dump, it shoots everywhere.
Yeah.
It leaves a toilet bowl and hits
the
wall.
But there's a difference.
The mechanics have a bathroom.
Bathroom.
And it is... You've never seen a bathroom like this.
That's why he's quarantined everyone in that bathroom, dude.
It is...
He probably has to wear hazmat suits and like power wash the bathroom.
You would have to wear a hazmat suit to clean that bathroom, dude.
Wait, I'm wondering. If I'm on Shane's side here.
I'm on your dad's side.
No, I think that there is a reason to say mechanics have the mechanics bathroom.
Yes,
but somebody coming in to just shoot a thing that he's
not. We're
gonna
film
not,
for fucking 9 hours.
Grease. That's
he's
the not, ass level of mechanic, though.
But. No.
Aspiring actor probably takes a very similar dump to a mechanic.
No, but the mechanic has like, is like covered in oil and whatever. Well, whatever. It's one of those things. So
that is funny. I got denied. I asked I stuck asylum in like a stranger's house. I was like, can I use your bathroom, sir? And they're like, what do you got to do? Actually, no. It was, we were playing basketball and we gave my friend laxatives. And then while we're playing, we're all like elbowing him in the stomach and stuff.
We actually called my friend. We had this weird phase where we were giving people laxatives when I was like in high school. And the first one we did, me and my cousin got laxatives and put them in chocolate milk and opened the, did you ever talk about this? And we opened the chocolate milk up and we brought chocolate milk to like four or five chocolate milks to my friends. And we each grabbed one that was good. We gave our one friend the one with laxative. Like, yo, Wawa just gave us free chocolate milk, dude. Let's drink up, play some basketball. So as he's drinking, we're like, yeah, drink it up, man. Come on, cheers.
Cheers. Chug that.
So we get him and chug his chocolate milk.
You're a terrifying human.
So then we're playing basketball, and the whole time we get a rebound, I'm like, whap, an elbow in his stomach. So we're all like hitting him. He's like, what the fuck's going on? And then he's like, oh my God, I got a shit. So he goes to this guy's house. He's like, can I use your bathroom? The guy's like, what do you got to do? And he goes, I got to do number two. And the guy goes, nope. I think he had to get picked up. And then he went home. He wasn't far from his house. But he... Dude, we did that. We gave girls laxative in high school.
Nice.
That was fantastic, dude.
It's like assault.
It is like assault.
I mean, not in high school. I didn't know.
True.
You know, he gave it. Yeah, I've talked about this.
Dude,
before.
I hope you get me too'd over
giving laxatives.
Roofying someone with the laxative.
We gave it. Oh man, that was horrible. It was mineral oil. I talked about this before.
No, I don't know. Did it to a lady?
In high school, we did it to a gang of ladies, dude. The three of them. We were drinking vodka at our house, and I would make shots, and then me and one of my boys would fucking, instead of shots, we would put mineral oil.
Oh my God.
So we fed this trio of chicks like four shots of mineral oil.
What happened?
Dude, so we went to the football, we went to the football game and followed them to like see what they would blow. So we went to the football game, and we're like, what the fuck? They're not shitting. We're like sitting there like, what's going on? And then we saw them leave, and we're like, oh, fuck, they're going to shit. So we followed them up to a Wendy's, and they had gone into a Wendy's, and we're blowing it out. We're knocking on the door like, where are you guys going? What's going on?
They suck refuge in a fucking Wendy's.
And then from the 202 Wendy's. And then my friend's like, yeah, you guys are drunk. I got to drive you home, even though they weren't really drunk. So my friend drove him home and hit all the bumps. He's like, I swear one of them shit themselves.
He was hitting bumps on purpose.
He was doing construction, so he was going bop, bop, bop. He's like, dude, I swear one of them shit.
Holy fuck.
It was fucked up, dude.
Damn, that friend is hilarious.
Oh, yeah. He's a fucking total beast.
Fuck.
Yeah, man. The more I'm like researching like behavioral disorders, my whole squad was conduct disorder, CD, anti-personality, antisocial. Dude, because the shit I'm hitting people with, that is like, I have to give a presentation on conduct disorder, and I'm like, no. If I were to fucking even just tell people what I was up to as a youth, dude, this whole class would be like, get out. You got to leave now.
Yeah.
But dude, in my head, I was like,
dude, you tell me shit. And I'm like,
I thought
you got to leave.
That made perfect sense to me. I was like, yeah, we'll slip him a little bit. Because we did it to my friend.
I mean, that's hilarious.
We did it to my friend. And then my cousin wanted to get out of school. So he was like, I wonder what this is like. And he dragged laxative.
What do you think? He's going to go home early? Because he had to shit.
He did it before school. So then he did it before school, so he could just like be in the bathroom shitting. So I told him, I'm like, dude,
you don't have to actually shit.
So I told him, I'm like, you could have just said you had diarrhea. And he was like, oh fuck. But he was like, well, I kind of want to see what it did. And he was like, he called my friend up and apologized. I'm like, dude, I didn't know how fucking bad that was.
Oh,
you drink
man.
A bunch of laxative, dude. Apparently, it's like you shit like a maniac.
Yeah,
that's awesome. You've definitely had laxative.
No,
really,
no.
Wow, I thought for sure.
I have pooped my pants in public, but not a laxative. You're just validating all my concerns about people.
Why?
Because that's the whole thing. I'm always like, I would sometimes get panicky if I left a drink.
Oh, for sure. Dude, I have a phobia of being poisoned. It probably stems from all the horrible shit
from
that I've done.
Poisoning people.
Pretty much, yeah. So yeah, I have like if I'm at Chipotle and I gotta go to the bathroom, I'll take my food with me and like take a piss and come back and put it back down.
Yeah, yeah.
I have my lax karma.
You bring your food into the bathroom.
Fuck yeah. I've started to not do it now. That's my big thing.
You can't do that.
I had to, bro. I thought someone was going to lax me back. I thought one of these fucking girls were going to come back and fucking mineral oil me up.
They definitely, you deserve it. But no, nobody's going to lax you.
Fuck, man. I deserve it.
We should probably go back to.
Yeah, when did you shit your pants?
Shitting your pants in public.
It was, I was in middle school and I had, I had like I didn't use the public restroom because
I never shit at my school in grade school.
Yeah.
Not yeah, once. When I was a kid, I didn't shit.
I don't like it.
I would go to the nurse's office.
Ooh, I got wow. Like, I got a little bellyache and go to the bathroom like ugh.
Yeah. So I was holding it in, and then
damn, so you'd only dump for the nurse.
In the, like, in
I got a present for you.
That's so funny. She definitely knew.
No, they she knew.
Yeah,
yeah. I would just come in and be like, I need to use the restroom. She okay, and then I just because they had a private.
Damn, you were probably such a little dork.
Yes.
You're so, probably adorable.
And so
oh, you're a God. Tiny boy, right?
Yeah, yeah.
She'd be like, Miss Green,
how tall
were
you? You recently got tall.
Yes. Yeah, because I was 5'2" my senior high school.
Whoa.
Yeah. Damn.
So you're a little boy, dude.
Yes.
You go seek dump asylum.
So I was. So I had to. I had diarrhea that morning, and then it was kind of one of those things where it was.
I love dorks with like. Well, I had diarrhea in the morning. For some reason, I'm just like, yeah, I shit weird. Like that's how I process.
It's like almost like a Civil War journal, yeah. Civil War general documenting yeah. their day. Like, well, I have diarrhea in the morning, and
yeah, early in the morn, I was struck with some mean grumbling in my tongue.
So you were prey walking through the hallways. Your stomach.
Yeah,
was
it was
like
one of those like diarrhea has that bizarre sensation that I can't quite articulate. My parents are blowing up my cell phone. Let me just make
it's sure. Probably a shit in the toilet. It's probably a shit in the
yeah. Someone's God. Definitely shit.
Someone took it.
Someone shit at work.
I'm just putting it on silent. It's like
someone must have took an unauthorized shit.
Yeah. So it's just like
I'm gonna take a fucking upper decker at your dad's work.
I'll be sure to tell him.
And let then, him know, dude.
Yeah.
I'll fucking swear
so,
out.
So it's that weird sensation where, like, there's like the diarrhea sort of rushes down,
yeah,
and
just blocks right at the butthole. Yes. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
You're like blocking it, and then it somehow goes away.
It didn't, like, yeah, and then right. It dissipates. Yeah, but you didn't block it.
So well, I had all day, and then it was eighth period. We're in gym class. We're playing kickball.
Oh, you had diarrhea in gym class?
When I kicked the ball.
No.
When you kicked.
Yeah, the ball. It, everything relaxed, and it was like brop. And then
what were you wearing?
Well, my PE uniform.
Shorts. So
was, yeah, yeah, my shorts PE and boxer uniform. Shorts.
It's just such a dork and, mentality. I don't know what.
But
it is.
Wasn't. It wasn't like full diarrhea. It was just like
just a squirt.
Brop. Yeah. And
was
then
it hot?
I yeah. ran the first.
And it was cold right away.
Ooh.
You know what I mean? Because that liquid's just sitting on it.
Ah.
Yeah.
I ran the first, and then I remember
you were on base with a shit in your pants.
I was single. On base there, like trying to. And then the next person had a double, and I remember getting a third. And there's this kid third. Sean playing third, and I think a piece dropped out. he was one of these kids, like, I was saying his chain is like a natural rhythm. He was like a natural athlete. And you know how, like...
He bird-dogged your turd on the ground?
He was, like, kind of... I just remember him, like, looking at whatever was on the ground, just, like, rubbing it with his foot, and, like, just kind of confused.
He stepped on it and mashed it around?
That's his shit at that point.
But it wasn't... He was just confused. It wasn't like he was... Yeah. You know, because I don't think the smell was wafting. And then I got home somehow, and I go into the locker room.
So you scored?
I can't remember if I scored or whether the period ended. But I went in the locker room.
You slid into home. And
you definitely got
big,
tagged out. Someone beamed you with the fucking ball.
It was just a big snail trail on the ground.
And then I went in the bathroom and
you
I
slid for
so...
50 feet.
Fuck, dude.
So you went to the bathroom.
I go in the bathroom and I was so embarrassed and I took my boxer shorts off and
sure.
I put my PE uniforms, my new boxers and my pants on and then I put my boxers in my lunch bag.
No, you throw them out.
Throw them out, you fucking weirdo.
And I came home and was trying to wash them in my sink.
Nah, dude.
And my mom walked in and was like, what are you doing? And I was like, and I started crying. I was like, And then she was like, why did you throw them out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Instead of washing your shit in the sink?
Yeah.
Damn, it's crazy your mom wasn't more sympathetic. She was like, why didn't you throw them out? You're like, I shit my pants.
Well, you ruined your
like,
lunch
well,
bag.
Well, she was like, it doesn't matter that you shit your pants. Just throw out your underwear.
That's a good lesson.
That's crazy. Soder shit his pants playing kickball as he kicked it.
I'll up your craziness one more level. Because I Wikipedia'd him the other day. We have the exact same birthday.
What the fuck?
Wow.
Yeah.
Soder shit his pants kicking the ball.
That's
it must
wild.
Be, what's
and then threw his pants out, threw his underwear out, and a kid fished him out. And was like, you shit your pants.
There's always someone on patrol for pants shitters.
He lies. He was older.
Oh.
He claims preschool, but you're not playing,
but
fucking,
not playing
you're not
fucking
playing
kickball
in preschool.
Preschool.
So Danny Sodis was probably a third grade dump.
Probably, dude.
Probably a fifth grade dump. Yeah, soda shit his pants in college.
For someone to be able to fish a fucking dump out of the trash, yep. You're talking like someone's gone through puberty at that
point. Yeah, and what up? Yeah, because in order to fish a dump out, you have to be like super vindictive and
for sure,
testosterone fueled, where you're just like, I got to destroy this other guy.
I mean, that was. I knew a couple people that fell by the wayside dumping their pants in fucking grade school, dude. That was a hard fuck. That was taking mortar shell, dude. Did you ever get discovered as a fucking dumper?
No, I don't think so. Nope.
I got away with one in third grade. I sharted right before the bell. Right before the buses came, I sharted. And then I did this weird, like, PR damage control where I was going around, like, you smell my shirt? It fucking stinks. I don't know what's going on.
Whoa! Yeah, that's impressive.
I was a psycho. Damn. I went around, I was like, I think my dog shit somewhere. I don't know. But everyone was like, cool. Like, everyone was like, yeah, definitely.
Wait, you what shit on the way to school?
I sharted at the end of the day.
And you were like, I think my dog shit somewhere?
Yeah, well, we were third grade.
Yeah, you're coming up with them.
I was pulling away with lies, dude. I was
holy
just
shit.
Trump daddy, dude. I'm fucking dumb. You're a razzle dazzle, dude. Daddy, dude. I was just lying. People were like, you shit. I was like, you're lying. Fuck you, dude.
Talk about getting ahead of the story.
Oh, God, sure.
No one even smelled it, but I was all over it.
Yeah.
I mean, I stunk.
You had a shit in your pants.
I had diarrhea in my trunks, dude.
I didn't really shit myself at all. A couple of my cousins fell by the wayside, sharting, shitting themselves a couple times, dude. But
it's such a dad, dude. If you full shit your pants, because especially where I was from, we all went to the same, grade school, high school, like from fucking kindergarten through 12th, right, we were all together in the same class
for sure,
like a small class. So like, if you shit your pants, everyone was like, "Yeah, that guy shit his pants," and you just weren't cool.
Yeah.
Like, for the rest of your life, it was like, remember was fourth
weird.
Grade?
It was weird, because we had a kid shit his pants in probably fourth grade, and everyone was just like, the day of, we were like, bah! But after a while, everyone was like, whatever.
Nice, you guys.
We were pretty progressive. My school was pretty progressive about shitting your pants. We had a lot of pants shitters, though, so I think it was like...
it was contagious. You guys were shitting. I think my favorite thing kids did was faint in church.
Oh, my God,
holy
dude.
Fuck. We went through a phase where kids were fainting. Every mass. One kid fainted right in front of me. And his head went back on the pew and right in front of me. And I was like, oh.
Yeah, my friend took one. He had like a weird thing where he started having fainting spells. And he went down. I remember he was laying by the kneeler. And we didn't know like what it was. And we were just like kicking him and shit. And we were like, get the fuck up, dude.
I had a kid have a seizure during a final.
Damn.
And as soon as he seizured out, I stole my friend's Scantron and copied it. Because everyone was taking care of this kid. Like, as soon as a dude had a seizure, I was like, give me that fucking test.
That's actually perfect, dude.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Nice.
Yeah, I did well, too.
Good for that kid, too. Taking one for the team, yeah.
Seizured out?
It was probably a false flag, so everyone could cheat.
Nah, it was not false, dude. He was like a... He had this weird thing where, like, he couldn't sweat.
Oh.
Whoa.
Whatever the fucking disease is, I don't know, but he would get crazy overheated.
What did he have to do?
I don't know, but it was hot during the finals.
Yeah, how did he fan himself down?
I don't know. I forget.
Damn, how do you sell? Like, so he couldn't maintain homeostasis.
No, he was always running hot.
What?
And he seized.
That'll fry your organs, dude. He seized up.
He seized out, dude.
Damn.
It was a hot test.
It's like Excite Bike, dude. He had to pull over for a minute.
Oh, man.
God dang.
Seizures are terrifying.
Oh, yeah, dude.
You ever see someone have a seizure?
I think so.
Fucking wild,
in high school, I did, yeah. I remember we learned you had to push up in, like, the bottom of their throat and keep them from biting off their tongue.
I watched a lady do it. I was at Notre Dame, Michigan,
mm-hmm.
and before the game, I saw this girl like talking to her boyfriend, and I could see her face. It was so weird that like I was staring at her. I was like, "This is I've never
She's
seen."
She's getting ready for a.
She's making like a weird scared face, like
Shit.
Holding her boyfriend, and he was like looking at her like, "What the fuck are you doing?"
Oh my God!
And then she like dropped down, stayed on her feet, but she like dropped down, got her eagle on real quick, and then popped back up and was like. Like about, and then she fell and had a fucking like hard
God
seizure.
Damn,
and I was
dude.
Just standing there like fucking hammered, like, whoa.
That's
help,
terrifying.
Help.
Right away, you're like, I think that lady shit her pants. I think that lady shit her pants.
I immediately ran over and scalped their tickets.
Did you really?
Yeah, I was like, you don't need that lady's ticket, dude. She's got to go to the hospital. I'll give you $20.
Take her out of there.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. What you think about that, Gerben?
What's this? I mean, scary. Seizures are scary.
You yeah. strike me as a guy who could have seizures.
I hope not.
Yeah, I hope you do. God. I hope you start getting them.
Well,
I hope not.
No, of course not. But, you know, you got health issues, right?
Yeah. But let's just hope that that's where they end.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. If you were going to seize, you'd have seized up by now.
I hope so.
Yeah, that's not going to kick in on you late, I don't think.
Yeah. I think they might kick in.
Well, you can. If you're like a... I think a lot of rappers were getting seizures. Lil Wayne had them. Rick Ross. I think if you started like consuming promethazine real heavy, you might be able to seize up.
What is promethazine?
It's a scissor. Yeah, it's a purple drink.
Let's get some purple drink. Get some codeine, scissor promethazine. In your fucking seltzer waters.
Pull up an eight. Yeah, you know what promethazine is?
No.
Codeine cough syrup.
Oh, okay.
That's prometh. That's syrup. That's okay. What they're sipping on syrup.
Okay.
Pull up a foe.
All new to me. I mean,
it's 4 ounces of fucking syrup.
So they just sip on.
Yeah,
NyQuil?
Sip on. No, it's not NyQuil. It's promethazine and codeine.
Come on, dog. Come on.
NyQuil is what's in that, like DXM, dextro.
Yeah, you can't fucking dent them out and not know what syrup is.
True.
Yeah, no, I don't know what syrup is.
You don't even know syrup.
I'm not gonna be no.
I used to be deep in the syrup game, dude.
Where
when
are
I was
you?
19, I used to cop pints for, and some guy told me you like mix it with Karo syrup and you can. That's how you cut. That's how you know you get bad syrup. If you crack your fucking bottle of syrup. And it's all like sugar crusted around the top. Someone cut your shit with Karo syrup. So I know you got bad scissor. I bought it once and tried to sell it. My friend just drank it all and drove his car into a hill. I was like, fuck, dude. I lost like $240.
That's sick. He drank it all.
I was like, dude, I'm going to hold this. I thought it was so funny that I had scissor up. And I was selling little shots of scissor up. So I was like, hold it at your house. Don't, and he just fucking downed like 8 ounces
of shit.
Damn,
you were selling scissor as
a
young man?
Yeah, when I was 19, yeah. And he fucking, he was
like Mike Jones.
Juice
dude.
Man, baby. Dude, he fucking, my friend was, I was like, dude, where are you at? I need my fucking scissor.
Damn.
No one was buying it.
Would you listen to Chopped and Screwed?
Oh, for
rap?
Sure, dude. I drank it. I got fucked up.
Fuck.
I drank, dude, scissor up fucks you up.
I bet.
It's, well, you have to take like, if you take like a painkiller and drink scissor up, it fucking bucks you, dude.
What does it feel like?
If you take like a painkiller, I'm not advocating this first of all, but if you take like a painkiller, drink scissor up, you lay down and you feel like you're floating. You're like, you're kind
of, you can't feel your body, right?
No, you're like in and out of sleep. So like you're like laying there and you're kind of, I mean, you're basically dipping out. You're like half asleep, half awake, and you're just kind of like laying there, kind of like you're like an orb, just like. I didn't care for it, honestly.
Yeah.
But
yeah, you like taking a trip mentally.
I like bugging out. Yeah, I'm not really into like, you know, I'm not trying to re-enter the womb, bro.
Yeah.
That's the choice you make every day. You wake up, you got the twin gremlins of anxiety and depression. I'm going for the unknown. People, more depressed types kind of hang back and just sort of like, meh.
Yeah, I'm more, like, I go with the depressed guy.
You choose.
I try to black out on alcohol.
Nah, dude.
I try to numb everything. You try to fucking,
I
want to
know too much.
It.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I'm a big fucking,
I mean, that's why this yin and yang, dude.
Exactly.
That's why this podcast
where do you
is
fall,
fucking
Gerbs?
Elite.
Oh, definitely the alcohol.
Really?
Oh, yeah, my
Gerbs
God.
Gerbs tries to numb the pain, dude.
Seeking the, that's true. A fucking bad boy like that, dude.
Yeah. With this lifestyle? Come on, dude. You got to forget those demons. You shit your pants playing kickball. You fucking.
I love alcohol.
It's great.
Really? I don't really like it that much. I mean, it's fun. If you catch me on a summer day and start feeding me alcohol, I'm not going
to
stop drinking until I black
we
out.
We got to go to the beach.
That is, yeah, we do. That was so fucking
that is
fun.
So fucking fun.
Yeah, if you put
organic
me
in, way to get some topless photos of my.
Yeah, yeah, you.
Oh,
topless.
You need. Yeah, just take a winter pic, dude. Let them know.
Go out and yeah, go out right now.
No.
You should go on a date with no shirt on.
And
you gotta get tatted too.
I have a tat.
What tat you got?
It's just like a lizard.
What? What?
Wait, you got the Sobe logo.
Yeah, it was regrettable. My cousin had gotten a lizard tattoo, so I got one. So I thought it was going to be in a plane crash.
Wait.
Yeah.
Let me see your lizard tattoo.
It's on my shoulder.
Let me see it.
What's it look like?
Like a Geico lizard. It's
no,
so stupid.
Dude.
Oh, my
it's
God.
Literally.
Damn, Gerby's is unbuttoning the denim.
Oh, we always get him to undress. Let me see that scapular
take
wing.
Take your shirt
dude.
Off, dude.
I'm not taking a shirt off.
Holy shit. What the
damn,
fuck?
Bro.
Gerby has a tribal lizard tattoo.
Really stupid.
You got an iguana?
Yeah.
Jersey,
yeah.
My tat, dude. You fucking don't tread on me, snake.
That is a retarded snake.
Snake in the desert, dude.
Okay. That's good. We've got similar creatures.
Yeah, we got some. We're definitely like.
Yeah, dude.
That makes sense.
Yeah, both you guys are just
very
wild,
reptilian.
Dude.
Cold
fucking
and reptilian.
Wow.
Yeah. Damn, that's sick. We
I
got
gotta
tats.
Get a dumb fucking
you
animal
get tatted
on my shoulder.
A tattoo?
I don't know what tat I
dude,
should
you
get.
Got
what tat
if you
I get?
Got a teardrop under your eye, you would blow
no,
up, dude.
No, don't do that.
You would fucking blow
especially
up.
Especially because, yeah, I'm balding now, so I'll have like a, I'll look like just a regular dad.
You should know, no.
Put on Propecia.
Nah, doesn't that fuck you up?
No.
Yeah, definitely,
dude. I'm not doing that. Fuck it. I'm going bald. I'll look sick.
Go
bald,
dude.
Yeah.
Go bald.
Yeah.
Just
happy,
copy
bald.
All of Joe Rogan's tattoos.
True.
Get the dimethyltryptamine on
well,
your arm.
Well, I can't get tattoos because I have a fat, flabby body. It'll look retarded.
Doesn't matter.
Get on your shoulder.
That'll look sick, dude.
Fuck, your shoulder, both you guys have retarded
tattoos. No, my tattoo's sick, dude.
Your tattoo is now funny. When you got it, trying to be cool, it sucked. Now it's hilarious. Matt has a don't tread on me.
It says don't tread on me? That's pretty cool.
I try to cover up the lettering and with like a shittier tattoo over it. So now it's just like this desert and this snake and this like
now.
Girly desert with like friendly looking cactuses.
Can I just see it? Yeah,
the snake, the desert, it looks like an 80s airbrushed t-shirt.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, dude. And then I thought they're going to cover
up. Damn, the boys are popping the shirts off.
I thought they were going to fucking
cover. Why are you taking your shirt off?
I was going to show him mine.
Let me see it. Let me see the full thing.
Yo, Curves is fucking ripped. Dude. Fucking.
Oh, man.
Who wants some of that, dude?
Yeah, there's more going on.
Look how fucking sharp that cactus is, dude. Look how sharp that cactus is, dude. If you sat on that, your ass would fucking hurt.
Yeah, I like yours better.
Damn, dude. No way, dude. Yours is fucking sick.
It's so fucking crazy that you have a fucking lizard tattoo.
Why'd you get that Liz on you?
I was like, I kind of said, I hit mild turbulence in a plane. I thought I was going to die. And I was like, if I get out of here, I'm going to, you know, get a tattoo. And I always
Jesus Christ,
damn,
dude.
Yeah.
You had a fucking bump on an airplane and got a Liz tattoo.
I was trying to impress somebody.
Who?
This girl.
How would you say about the Liz tat?
Of course she didn't care. I mean, it's just...
Wait, how'd you reveal the tat to her?
I don't even remember how the reveal happened.
Yeah, you do.
No, I swear.
Yeah,
I don't.
You fucking do.
I swear
do.
I don't. I'm telling you.
Oh, my God.
Well, you're very premeditated in like your sleeve position, so you probably just rolled them up. Wow. Gerbs, you're looking fucking ripped, bro.
Yeah,
look at that.
Yo, I have my finger on the mic.
You got abs,
Gerbs,
dude.
Gerbs, fucking ripped. Gerbs, you're fucking chiseled, dude. God damn, you're
Shane,
made out
Shane
of marble,
punched
bro.
Me in the stomach, yeah. I pinched my stomach.
Dude, you look fucking sick, dude.
Curbs, you're made out of fucking marble, dude.
Yeah, right.
No,
thank
I'm
you.
Serious.
Thank you.
Curbs, you're fucking shredded.
Thanks, man.
You're fucking dried
I'm
out,
working
dude.
On it. I'm working on it.
You're fucking totally dried out. I'm that serious.
Oh, okay.
I'm not fucking around.
Oh, fuck.
Damn, dude.
Anyway,
fucking Bruce Lee, dude.
Yeah, I don't. Dude, I think I've said this on this podcast before.
Damn.
The way I honestly thought you dated women. And this was, like, in college. But also because, you know, I didn't date at all, given that I was 5'2". You know, I hadn't hit puberty until I got to college. But it was, like, the Friends mentality. You know, like the show, Air Quotes Friends, where it's, like, you, Ross, and Rachel, you become her friend.
Oh,
and then
man.
And that's what I did with this girl. And it was, like, 2.5 years of my life.
Damn.
Just fawning over this one fucking...
And she loved it, dude.
She loved it.
Oh, of course. She definitely loved it.
Of course.
It.
And, I mean, it's just, you know... that I look back on mortified. Of all the, like, I'm fine with pickup artistry and that all that silliness. Mm,
you shouldn't be, but all right.
No, you know what I mean. I'm not okay
with
it.
For sure.
Yeah.
Boy, that would keep me up at night.
Yeah, dude, I used to rock a shell necklace on the fucking boardwalk and just try to hit on girls. I'm like,
I'm fine with, like, because it was a quick thing, and then it's just like, I'm fine with the trying.
Sure.
And failing, but it's like, but to be with about one girl and to be like,
What year was this? What grade?
I met her my freshman year, so it was like all freshman year through sophomore year.
Damn, so you were all high school like, there she goes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you almost hit that high note.
Absolutely.
There she goes.
So it was high school, freshman, sophomore.
No.
College.
Yeah. Oh no!
And you were just
you were
a growing boy,
right?
You were. She probably took a week off of seeing you and came back, and you were 5 inches taller.
Yeah, but still, just as not.
Damn! What the fuck was it like growing when you're older? That's fucking weird,
that's
right?
That's awesome.
Like, weird, yeah. It was.
I guess you don't.
A little weird,
did you notice it? Like, did it hurt?
It like a
werewolf. Were you like,
no.
Damn.
But, yeah, it was good. I mean, I was, like, very pleased. Because when I went to the endocrinologist, which I don't know if I said on this podcast before, but, like, where they literally compare your testicles to a bead of wooden testicles that denotes the proper growth of testicles.
What?
Yeah,
no?
So that's, I was like,
what kind of doctor is this?
Endocrinologist.
Check out my sack's doing, dude.
I got a fucking guy sonogrammed my sack.
Whoa.
When?
Yeah. I thought I had appendicitis. And they're like, do your balls hurt? And I was like, well, yeah, now that I'm thinking about it.
Exactly.
Yeah, they've hurt. Because you know how your balls occasionally just hurt?
Yeah, for sure.
So I was like, yes.
You get like a random dick pain. You're just walking. Yeah. You're like, oh.
So then they fucking put the, this dude put gel on my nutsack and sonogrammed it.
Yeah. Ooh, and like I just flinched.
It felt good.
I didn't. No, I just
felt fucking real twitched. Good.
I bet.
But this dude, he did not. He did not have a good sense of humor. I thought it was hilarious.
What'd you say?
He was like doing it, and you can hear the pulse. You can. There's a noise. You can hear the blood coursing through your fucking dick.
Yeah, because you're getting a boner.
It's like, yeah, it's like you hear the thing, like the pump of blood in your fucking nutsack.
Damn.
And I started laughing. I was like, "What's that?" And he explained it, and I was like, "Yes, dude." Because this was like 3 years ago. Like I was talking shit to this guy. God. I thought it was funny, and he was furious.
Why was he so mad?
Probably because he was looking at my dick and nuts. I'm just sure, laying there, dude. A fat dude just laying on the table laughing at him. I'm like, thanks, nurse. Thanks for the ball check, nurse. He's like, your testicles are totally fine. Why are you here?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Should I remember put that he had fucking
like a,
thing back
he had
up
like
there?
A Pittsburgh Steelers fucking, what are those called?
Beanie?
Like a scrub
like
hat?
Like a scrub hat with oh, Steelers.
Right. Oh, he was one of those like edgy nurses who wore like a...
Yeah.
Dude, stop.
I was like, check my nuts, dude.
Ball doctor, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Dude, imagine, saying? No,
I was
for real,
fucking with him.
Imagine you're at your work and they're just like, all right, you gotta go check that guy's dick out. I'd be like, what?
I mean, if that's your job, and then if the guy made a joke while you're doing it, I'd be like, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
like,
but that's you'd laugh. That's sketchy territory, dude. You can get lured into a joke, and then you can just be like, this guy harassed me.
True.
I think that's like number one. That's like a whole class in nurse school where they're like, don't be fucking laughing about when you're checking out dicks.
Oh, okay. You probably meant
like
from him.
People are gonna be. It'd be like it's hilarious when you're looking at someone's dick, and they're gonna be funny. But you gotta. They're like the dudes who stand outside like the Queen of England's place, dude.
Right.
It's like Knight's Guard. They have the stone wall.
Can't make him laugh.
Can't even. They
I thought
can't
I could have broken, but he ended up getting mad at me. I was like, all right, man. Yeah. So they have these wooden models of testicles at your endocrinologist.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So anyway, they only thought I was going to make it to like 5'6", but you know, I'm up there around 6 foot.
Judging by your balls.
Right.
What if, have you stopped like, growing?
And x-rays.
I hope you don't stop growing, dude.
So he's like, grab your, you balls and close his eyes and is like, 5'6", he'll be.
No, that was from an x-ray. Oh. Yeah, yeah. They somehow look at your bones.
The boy will be 5'6" and no taller.
Damn, they just touch balls and decide that?
Yeah.
It's a real humiliating test, yeah.
Oh.
So how what is this just sack they hold? Like how realistic does this sack look?
It looks really realistic. I forget what the there's a
how's the action on it? Do, like the balls move around in there or like is it
it's
pretty
like
rigid?
Worry beads.
What?
But they're just testicles. There's a name for it. I forget what, but you could just Google.
I'm going to get one of these
truck anyway, nuts.
Truck
nuts. God just has a bunch of truck nuts.
Yeah. When I got my sonogram, I was kind of hoping that they would say something about erections. I think we talked about this, too, at one point. But I wanted them to give a disclaimer. It's like, it's okay if you get an erection. Just want to say this.
If you get an erection during a nutsack sonogram, you're a psycho.
I don't think so.
Yeah, you are. It's like cold.
Who was giving it to you?
Oh, yeah. Did you have a Pittsburgh Steelers fan or
no,
did you have a lady?
It was a lady.
Oh, all right. Dude. There yeah, 100%. Right. Yeah, my bad. There's my nothing bad. Wrong with that.
And it's also, it's just one of those things
it's
where
your
it's
balls,
just,
too, dude. Like, if someone touches your balls, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
Feels
be
good.
Gentle. Be gentle.
Yeah, feels ooh. That guy, that fucking Steelers fan, was probably whipping the terrible towel on your fucking balls. So she was gentle. You had an angel
she's
touching
gentle,
your
and I get erections very easily.
Really?
Yeah.
It's funny how often we cover like nurses touching our dicks and balls and being like, they're the best. They're angels.
So, you got hard.
No, I didn't. But I was really hoping
you wanted the option.
I wanted that option. I remember I heard this somewhere, and I think it was about sex on like simulated sex for a movie.
Sure.
Where some actress told this to the male actor. She's like, "It's cool if you do, cool if you don't." Insofar as like getting an erection.
So I mean, it's not her fucking choice.
No,
his
I think
body.
She was just trying to make him feel comfortable,
oh,
which
like,
I think is a good thing.
I thought you meant, like, penetrate. I was like, fuck.
Damn.
Oh, no. Just like, you know.
The Sex and the City girls had sex every time.
For sure. 100%.
Every sex scene in that was real penetration.
No. It was like, did you ever see the D'Angelo music video where he's getting
yeah,
a blowjob?
Yeah, getting his dick sucked
yeah,
the whole
dude,
time?
The whole time.
I knew when I was a young boy something about that video was
I knew it.
Making me hard.
I think Sex and the City, they had, like, mutual fluffers who were out of frame who would just, like, suck the guy's dick and eat Sarah Jessica's pussy. Dude. Or they're just on like a double-ended dildo.
Classified. We will now return to the broadcast.
I did it. I had a. I'm getting better at lucid dreaming. I wake up in the middle of fucking night all the time now.
Okay.
Wake up at like, I've been going to bed super early, like 9:30. I wake up at like 3, and I usually like let my dog take like a piss or whatever. So, dude, I've been laying down, and, like, last night I was up for a couple hours. sleep wouldn't come. I'm like, it'll come. And I know when I interrupt my – that's how you have lucid dreams. You interrupt your sleep on purpose.
Yeah.
You fall back asleep around like 4 in the morning. Dude, I finally – I was in a room in a dream, and I was like – I was like, holy fuck, this is a dream. And then my heart would start beating real fast. I'm like, oh, easy, easy. I got that under control. And I was like, oh, I want some pussy. And I instantly just snapped out of it. I was like, fuck, no. So I entered the astral realm, oh, fucking you're demanded pussy. The Matrix,
where you're like, I can control. Whoa.
Yeah, literally.
I can control everything.
I was like, I'm a pussy. And I just instantly got snapped out of it. I was like, God damn it.
It's funny how that works.
It's nuts, dude.
In dream, I mean, particularly in...
I've never had a lucid...
I've never had one where I was controlling anything like that. But I meant like in a sex dream. It's always how you wake up right when you're like, finally, we're going to fuck.
Yeah. Dude, I finally, like, as I kept doing that, I get like sleep paralysis and I would just go into it and have these weird like loop dreams. I finally was my first steps of my baby steps, dude, in the astral plane. I was like, step. And I'm like, oh my God.
Like, I can control everything.
Literally. And I just fucking woke. My heart was beating real fast though, dude.
It's how you're getting there.
No, it's weird.
Damn.
So when I used to wear my Apple Watch to monitor my heartbeat while I slept, my heart spikes at nighttime. It goes up to like 140. Is that super high? It goes up to like 120. Like it'll spike up pretty high and then come down. So I didn't know if the watch was defective or not. But I entered the astral plane, dude. My heart was like, boo, 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 and I would have to be like, I could have just been dreaming this. I don't know. And I was like, whoa, slow down. It instantly slowed down, so I probably wasn't dreaming it. Then I tried to fucking demand.
Nah, dude. That's reality. I tried to
demand pussy in the astral realm, and they were just like, be gone. And I was like, fuck.
Next time, what are you going to ask for next time you're in the astral realm?
I don't know. I'm just going to walk around. I'm going to keep a low profile.
You
got to
ask people for some secrets.
True. I gotta keep a low profile. I went in, it's too hot, dude.
Yeah, you went in and were like, yo, where's the fucking pussy
dude, the
at?
Ancients were like, get the fuck out. But yeah, it's been awesome, man. I've been going to bed at like 9:30. You get like awesome sleep, and then I wake up at like, if I'm lucky enough, I'll get woken up in the middle of the night by my dog. My dog's my spirit guide.
Yeah.
He's like, watch me shit, and then you can travel the astral plane.
Wow.
So yeah, that's been fucking tight, dude.
That's awesome.
It's pretty awesome. I'm getting like good at it because I used to read about people lucid dreaming and I was like, bullshit. There's no way you can like train yourself to do it. I'm getting close. I took literally 3 steps in a dream that I was fully like, oh yeah, and just fucking crazy.
Good.
Damn.
Crazy ass shit.
It's funny how gay I feel about talking about those chicks.
Why?
I'm just instantly, I'm just like, I shouldn't have brought that.
That's a fucking hilarious story.
You thought they were a fucking dickhead.
Well, you thought there were three comedy babes that were just like, because that is every comedy show. I was like, yeah, man.
Well, this was also right on the heels. And the funny part of it was I was looking at my phone when she said who they worked for.
Think he's going to get back to her?
And I instantly put my phone down and I was like, oh, well, now I'll respect you. My bad. Like I said that.
What'd she say?
They laughed a little, but I was being a dickhead. I'd just done an audition for this thing. The show was an audition.
Sure.
And the judges were there at a table.
Oh, this wasn't last night.
No, this was Friday night.
Oh.
Friday night.
So the chances of there was dusty there.
The industry was there.
Yeah, there was dusty. Yeah.
But then I did the judges were at this table.
Yeah.
And at the end of my set, this guy was like, this guy was laughing real hard. So I was like, yeah, fuck yeah, dude. And then he was like, he just screamed. He was like, that was fucking hilarious. And for some reason, I pointed at the judges, and I was like, yeah, you fucking hear that, dickheads? That's it for me. That's how I closed it.
Oh, my God.
Like, as soon as I was like, yeah, you hear that, you dickhead? I was like, oh,
fantastic,
fuck. What
dude.
The fuck was that?
No way, dude. You got to fucking...
Yeah, but it wasn't... I was in the astral realm, dude. I was just floating.
Well, dude, you're...
This guy said that was great. I pointed at the judges. I was like, you don't fucking judge me, you dickhead, left.
Yeah, that's how you do it.
It was crazy. And then I walked outside, and they're like, well, yeah, we booked this show. I was like, oh, now I'll give you respect. Like, it was crazy.
Damn.
I was being a fucking asshole.
Well, you know... Go ahead, Gerbs.
Well, no, go ahead. You go, and then I'll...
This is my latest kick that all I'm reading about, dude, is the unconscious and how, like, you're really, like, your waking consciousness is, like, a sliver of, like, what your brain's really up to.
That was
so you're up there doing
fucking...
it, and you're just like, oh, fuck you guys. And it's like, dude, that's going on in the background all the time.
That was full on, like, as soon as I said it, I was like, that wasn't what I meant to say at all. Like, I would have never said that.
How the judges
liked
it.
They liked my set.
How the judges like getting fucking called out.
I don't think they heard it on the first go. Otherwise, they'd be like, the fuck was that?
But
they did tape it. JFL.
Okay.
I mean, that's actually really funny in place.
It is funny.
In that setting where it's like, you hear that? You're like, I'm sure they kind of laughed.
Yeah.
But so I'm sure you weren't like, you hear that, you fucking dickhead.
It wasn't like that. I was like, yeah, you hear that, you dickheads? I was like, that's it for me. Like, that's what I closed on.
That's hilarious. Whenever someone can step outside of what's going on, like, there's people going up like, oh, the judges. Yeah. If you can, like, fuck around about the whole thing,
yeah,
that doesn't hurt.
Well, that's what helped me. I was on my way to another show, and I got a text. They were like, can you get to this? There's an extra spot for you on this audition. But the show started 10 minutes ago. So what helped was I didn't have any time to prepare.
That's great.
I would have spent the whole day being like, how can I get this set to 5 minutes?
True.
This is a 5 minute spot.
Just let it rip.
So then I was able to just show up and be like, oh, I'm fucking lucky to be here.
That's the best.
It was easy.
That is tight. You weren't ruminating about it all day. Go ahead, Gerbs.
Yeah. I feel like.
Don't give me. Like, all right, go ahead.
What? Don't give me what?
Nothing. Go.
Rip it, Gerbs.
No.
Nothing. Shut up. Just go. Nice top, dude. Just fucking go.
No, I was just going to ask because I feel like, you know. What at least for me, I try to. I'm trying to figure out how much do you let other people, what other people think of you, impact? Because it can be debilitating if you're really worried about what other people think. But then again, if you're just not, if you don't care at all, then that's like you got a network. So especially with your sort of personality and your stand up, it's an aggressive style of like so. It feels like that's tough to modulate in the moment where...
That's what fucked me last night.
Right.
Last night I did give a fuck.
Yeah.
Like when people got upset, I let it fuck up the first 20 minutes of my set.
Yeah, it sucks.
And it was, there was a gay dude in the front row that was like offended a couple times.
Really?
Yeah.
What'd he say?
I could just see him. I could see his face. There was four old people, three rows back. Yeah, me being like, Trump's number one, stuff like, yeah, but of course I'm kidding.
Right.
I'm on stage.
Is Trump attacking gays?
Is he attacking gays?
He's not an ally. Trump's not an ally.
I don't know. I think he had a rainbow flag at the RNC. He had a fucking...
What?
Yeah, Trump, I mean, obviously he's not a fucking ally, but like... I think
it's funny how he's lumped in with all of that, dude.
More of the homophobia and racism and shit, to me, is a weapon, a political weapon against him.
Sure.
So it kind of bothers me when people are like, he's racist or he's transphobic.
Yeah.
It's like, why? Right. Did you hear that? Give me an example. It's like, well, he wants to ban trans from the military. It's like, all right, that one's a rough one, but
yeah,
it's tough to argue, but whatever.
I mean, dude, my whole thing is like, I don't know. Yeah, exactly.
I'm not
fucking
defending the dog.
I'm not boots on the ground, dude.
I'm not boots on the ground. I'm not boots and butts, dude.
My thing is military is life or death. I mean, there's a bunch of bullshit ass jobs in the military. So, you know.
Yeah. If you want a couple trans fucking, I don't know what would they do?
Stockroom? A little stockroom?
Get them in the stockroom, dude.
What do you think?
Trans.
Well, it's kind of damned if you do, damned if you don't, because you put them on the front lines. You're like, what the fuck? They're stacking the front lines with trans.
If we stack the front line with trans,
I mean,
ISIS
that would
is
be
in trouble.
Oh my god, dude!
Damn,
ISIS would fucking they'd lose their minds.
ISIS would just be correcting their pronouns the whole time, just storming, going house to house, correcting people.
Excuse me.
Kicking down the door and be like, "What did you say? This room's clear.
I respect your culture."
Yeah.
That's true. That would be a hard risk of a double agent. So you'd respect Muslim culture too much.
What? Trans?
Yeah.
They love Muslim culture.
Dude, I've been having feminists almost stick up for female genital mutilation or female genital cutting, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
I've had like in,
like, that's
in
their
school.
Custom, and you don't know.
Exactly. In school to be like, they'll be like, well, you know, it's like you don't know like what it like is. Maybe it's a clean center. I'm like, are you familiar at all with the procedure? Like, it doesn't matter. They're chopping fucking. They're like, well, they do it to boys. I'm like, they're not like cutting the tip of my penis off, dude.
Yeah.
And it's like, I'm not exactly stoked on that either. But you'll get girls who are feminists who are just like, it's like, dude, they're like pull string. It's like whatever is in that moment, that's all they say. And there's no connect the dots or larger
it's
thinking.
Nuts.
It's crazy, dude.
Dude, the American Academy of Pediatrics for a bit allowed what's called genital nicking for girls, which is like, if you want to take you just want to get some blood out of the clitoris because it's for the custom, right? So instead
you
of letting
can pump it down a little?
Right. So instead of letting you take the whole, you know, size of the clitoris.
You just deflate it?
Yeah, you just nick it. And everybody was like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And there was like outrage here, rightfully so.
It's crazy.
Yeah, but that's...
Just
Google that.
It's called what?
Genital nicking.
Nicking?
And then they had to reverse their position on it. You know, you nick it.
And they were just kind of like, well, yeah, we're not about that anymore.
They wanted,
who was trying to do this, though?
Well, for female genital mutilation.
Oh, this is like,
that was like, their way of trying to be like, you could still fuck with it, but just not to the point that you're removing the clitoris.
Yeah,
you just can't. They're trying to, like, negotiate with insane people.
That's, dude, I'm telling you, and I have these ladies, I'm like, why, how are you guys against this?
It's crazy.
If I was like, Trump wants to take your clits, they'd be fucking, they'd be furious, dude.
They'd be fucking pissed.
And it's like they're acting like it's like it's not the girl's choice either. I was like, if these girls were like, we want our clits cut off, I'd be like, all right, man, you fucking weirdos, I'll give you that. But it's like,
sure.
If you're 18.
This is a patriarchal custom of like the father.
No. If you're eight, what do you mean you're 18? What if I have a young daughter and she identifies as someone without a clit?
True.
My position would be no. You have to wait. I'd say yes. You absolutely.
You gotta run the mower over that pussy, dude.
Yeah, I would take her out back, break out the John Deere, knock that clit off, dude.
Yeah, dude, it's fucking horrible.
Set those wheels real low.
Yeah,
shit's fucking nuts, dude. I would
come close to actually. I'm sorry, Matt.
Go ahead, please.
Coming closer to the whole 25. I mean, I could back myself in.
What's the whole 25 here?
Well, that's when we know the brain is fully developed.
Oh, that's when you can...
Yeah, I think, like, they're you know...
I think you're going to come up with a 0% women electing to cut off their clits at fucking 26. But, yeah, that should be the option.
But then if we're letting people fight and die at 18, it's just tough to...
True. Should be able to chop off your clit for your country. Yeah.
So, 18 seems reasonable.
Dude, I'm blown away by this shit. I have, like... I'll, like, talk to people, and I'm like, are you, like, even, like, in reality... Like, you're sitting here, same person, be like, women's rights, blah, 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 and be like, well, it's their culture, and it's like... Because my whole thing, I was like, you guys have to, I know you guys stake your flag in the ground somewhere.
Yeah.
And it's like, you're against people using hateful speech online, but a girl getting her clitoris cut off, you're like, that's cool. It's fucking crazy, dude.
But then what I don't understand is like, also, it seems like applying a precedent doesn't compute for a lot of people, because if you're going to apply the precedent that we have to respect cultures, then why can't I just have a crazy culture that doesn't respect their culture, but you have to respect mine because of it?
A lot of Muslim cultures fucking hate ours, and you still have to respect it.
Right.
And with that, yeah. So that is already made. Somebody already has a culture that's like, kill everyone. And we still have to be like, yes. Very nice.
Yeah.
Not obviously not Muslim culture is not kill everyone, but you know what I'm saying.
Well, dude, no, exactly. But there, even the other day we were talking about how, like, what the fuck were they saying? How, like, early, there's like that period in early childhood where, like, if you fuck a kid up between, like, I think like 1 and 4 years old or maybe 6, I forget, but there's like a window where, like, that's where you do like irreversible damage. And they're like, so the school will talk about that. They're like, there's science to back this up. It like creates brain changes, everything. If you like do like, you're hitting kids, you're doing all kinds of crazy shit, like, in that pivotal age, like, it's like, people don't dispute this. So then they'll say this, and then they'll talk about, like, they have to do a caveat where they're like, well, in some cultures, it's actually okay to, like, hit your kids.
Right.
And my question was, like, well, but does a kid know? And if this is a biological change happening, the kid's not like, wait, what culture am I in? It's like, it doesn't matter. If that's real science, then you shouldn't do that ever, no matter what. And their lady was like... Yeah, I guess it is kind of complicated. Anyway, we're going to keep it like this. Don't want to fucking talk about it. It's so funny. Are they talking about
Indians hitting kids with shoes?
No.
Taking their sandals off?
They're just talking about it in general.
Look, man, I had immigrant parents, dude. You don't know what it's like. I had brown parents. Brown parents will slap the soul out of you, bro.
True, dude.
Oh, I was laughing because there was an Indian dude.
With those telemarketer hands, dude.
Yeah, they'll fucking slap you around. My dad was a chemist. All you hear is
the ringtone of like an analog phone. It's going...
I was listening to this Indian dude do stand-up the other night, and he also had a fucking... black guy voice.
Really?
Which is... I started laughing about it because it's like, oh, these are all first-generation like Indians. So they came to America when... And they had to come up with their own fucking accent.
True.
You know what I mean? So they're just like, what's the coolest accent right now?
That's not a bad
pick.
Talk
like a black dude. Talk like a fucking, I'm Drake.
Fair enough, dude.
That's what I was thinking. Because while the guy was up there, I was like, why does every fucking Indian comic now talk like fucking Drake?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh yeah, because Drake, or like, because that's cool now.
Yeah.
And they showed up and like, I'm not taking my fucking dad's dumb accent.
I mean, dude,
Dang, I'm not getting made fun of. What's the coolest accent?
In seventh grade, if I could have went like 6 shades darker, I would have been talking like RZA from the Wu-Tang Clan, dude, all day, every day.
Yeah, absolutely.
That makes sense. That's a very valid theory.
They got to choose their own adventure as soon as they got to America.
That is a funny thing that they've fallen into.
Yeah.
Where they're all of a sudden, it's like, and I'm like, look, Ma. And it's like, Like, dude, you're a fucking nerd.
It's like, yo, I came to this country. Like, yeah. I came here for opportunity.
It's like, dude.
What'd you say? Why are you talking like
that? Yeah, that is, that's definitely fucking strange.
Yeah.
Especially when they, like, I mean, I've talked about this 100 times, about they're like, yeah, be hitting, you don't know about this, hitting, and it's like, get the fuck out of here. It's like,
brown parents, they be hitting, y'all white parents.
Yeah.
And I fucking hate the brown.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, I'm brown. It's like, are you just trying to say black?
Yeah.
Are you just trying to be like, I'm right next to black. That's what I am.
Doesn't work that way, yeah, dude.
Fuck that.
Sorry, dude.
Sorry,
I mean,
dude.
Good move.
Y'all engines.
Good move.
Y'all are engines. Stay engine.
It's a good move.
Just be an engine.
It's a sick fucking move.
I appreciate it.
What do you think about Slazov Zizek?
I love that accent.
That is hilarious.
I love the southern accent.
What do you think about Slazov Zizek?
I don't know who that is.
He's an intellectual. He's left-leaning, but he also makes fun of all that shit.
Oh, really?
He talks about how it's a big power grab. A lot of that's just a big power grab.
Of course it is.
It's a big power grab based off, like, you use, like, victimhood as your, that's, like, your power token.
Yeah.
And, like, that's, I mean, you know, we've said it.
I mean, we're seeing it.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah,
now they're gaining political power with it.
Yeah, for sure. Dude, did you see the picture of Alexandra, whatever her name is, Octavia Cortez?
We can never say it. I just mumble it. I'm like, Alexandra Ocasio-Cortez?
Yeah, dude, Cortez.
She's so fucking hot, dude. I love her.
The one picture.
Me and her are in love, dude.
She was coming out of the thing, and there was just like four white dudes with their phones, and I think someone put it up as their meme, like, when the first time and no one cares who your dad is, and it's just her like storming out of a Capitol, Jesus. And there's like four white guys near her. It's just like, dude, what the fuck? That's insane.
Yeah, they're doing a real fucking bad job of fighting Trump.
Yeah, man.
They're doing they're the just
exact they're opposite. Doing
the worst fucking way to fucking beat Trump.
They got the game fucked up, dude. Again. They got to start catering towards like white trash, like West Virginia. Was there like they're attacking this like people who like Trump as like privileged, like trust fund babies? That's not the case. They're attacking themselves. Yeah. They need to start focus on like dudes who are down at like a just you drive past a dusty turnpike and they're just standing out there with a wrench waiting for a car. That's who they got to start going.
They got to find anything on the turnpike where there's a handwritten sign.
Yeah,
they need to fucking pull over and be like, "Who wrote that? We got to talk to them."
Because they keep going at them like they're all these like Wall Street tycoons kids, and it's like, dude, that's not who's fucking voting for Trump.
I mean, they are, but yes,
just, yeah,
that's a small there's huge, not that many.
Exactly, they got to start taking it towards the WT. If the Democratic Party
wants
wanted
a chance,
to,
they got to get the white trash.
Got to get the white trash.
Trump dad,
white trash votes, dude. White trash,
vote,
dude. That's a big vote right now. It's bigger than
the white trash vote.
Black vote was like swinging Trump's election. White trash vote's going to be huge when Democrats start. You know, like obviously run stuff for black people. Did you ever see that? Like maybe like McDonald's commercials and shit.
I mean,
like grandma, sweet tea is so sweet. Yeah. You ever see that?
Yeah, McDonald's commercials. They went full blackface. McDonald went full blackface.
You know how grandma used to make that sweet tea, dude.
I'm dude. Fucking loving it, y'all. It's like what? Come now and get some motherfucking chicken nuggets, you marky ass busters.
Dude, when the DNC does like white trash,
this
fucking
my second dip, dude. This Ooh. Is a two skull episode, dude.
You gotta skull up.
I gotta skull up. We're dude. Talking politics. I'm getting skulled
when
up.
When the DNC goes for the white trash. Vote.
You want to drink a beer right now?
Do you want to drink a beer?
Do you
Go ahead.
Have
I'm sorry,
beers?
I didn't mean to cut you off. I was thinking about bringing them. I didn't, so I shouldn't have even said it.
Yeah, what are you going to get knocked out, dude? Shut the fuck up.
Keep going, man.
No, I was just talking, dude. If they wisen up and start getting some, like, if the Democrats start doing some nice white trash commercials, I'll be so fucking pleased.
They should.
Dude, they have to. The fact that they're not, it's going to crush them.
What they're trying to create right now with this, like I haven't listened to enough of Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Yes.
But when I hear her talk, she stumbles a lot on her words. It sounds like she doesn't know what the fuck she's talking about a lot.
Really?
I mean, maybe because it's a lady yapping, and I don't like that. But no, for real, it sounds like she'll get fucking crushed by someone that knows what they're talking about.
Dude, I mean,
because she just goes on with like a platform of like, people shouldn't be poor.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, that
sucks.
Yeah,
that's our policy, too.
Yeah, for I sure. Mean,
yeah.
No, that's true. That'll be, I mean, dude, say what you will about Trump. He hasn't taken a day off, dude. He's been doing his talks.
No days off, dude.
He's been doing his fucking
talks. He's running his hour.
He's getting ready for these debates. It's going to be insane, dude. It's like Rocky, too.
His hour is sharp right now.
Yeah, it is.
I told you I was watching it.
He's going to shred Cortez,
I've been
bro.
Watching his debates, or his campaigns. Mm-hmm. He's been campaigning since day one.
Hasn't stopped, bro.
He literally hasn't stopped going to arenas and just being like, are we the best? Are we the best or what? I'm telling you, wow, we're really doing it.
Dude. Well, apparently people are mad right now because his tax thing where everyone got a little boost in their paychecks, it's like no one's getting a tax return now. That's a clear trick, dude.
Great trick, dude. I love it. He's very short term.
Very
in the moment.
Everyone was like, fuck yeah, dude, I got more money in my check. I got more money. And now apparently everyone's filing their taxes and their accountant's like, yeah, you're not really getting anything back. I'm like, what the fuck? He just changed everyone from like a zero to a two.
Yeah. Did you watch the State of the Union?
No, I didn't see it.
You gotta watch
it. Heard it was very measured.
Dude, I watched the State of the Union and I was like, fucking damn.
What'd he say?
Trump dog was he fucking nose breathing? Brought it.
Was he,
he wasn't totally nose breathing, but he did have a couple of those.
That's not
when
bad.
He gets real serious, he's
yeah.
What we need to do, yeah.
Apparently it was real measured, but they attacked him. They were like, what'd they say? It was like, well, yeah, well, why is he so measured? Because secretly,
yeah, of course. But it was actually a fucking sick speech. He brought some dudes in from D-Day. He was like, these guys are the
that's
fucking
one of his
shit.
Yeah, that's one of his top moves, to stand behind a vet like that. Yeah. And just be like, what a great guy.
I mean, wow. He brought in a border patrol dude. He brought what? In like, he was like, that guy came here illegally. And now he fucking defends our country. It was like, woo.
Now he's a fucking coyote. He probably gets paid off. And fucking
but Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, she showed up, her and all the other hot babes showed up in all white and sat
Stop,
together.
Bro. That's kind of nice.
And like the black ladies had like African sashes on.
Sure.
The one, who's the one with the fucking, there's a Muslim lady. She's the first.
I know you're talking about. Yeah.
She was there. At one point she like hands on fate. Like it was what you were saying about everybody's trying to be a gif.
Yeah.
Everyone in there was trying to be a meme or a gif.
What?
It was hilarious. At one point, though, this was a weird part.
Trump, wait, they were there at the State of the Union, just all in all white?
Yeah. But Trump, at one point, was like, under our administration right now, women have the most jobs they've ever had. And that was the first time all those women stood up and clapped. And then they sat back down. He was like, no, stand back up. You're going to like this next one. Nailed them. They had to stand up and clap.
No.
And he was like, this is the most women we've ever had in politics. And they all did that again. And he was like, that's really great. It's really great for you guys. Congratulations. That's really great. Then he went back to his speech. It was fucking
oh my goodness.
Yeah.
I didn't even watch
but
it.
But really during his speech when they
just
like
stand up
clapped
and, gonna...
and then they all sat down. He's like, no, you guys are going to want to stand back up for this next one.
He just
nailed
strictly
him.
Deals in power moves.
Dude. Dude. They tried to show up in like all white as like unity against him.
Yeah.
And he still was like, what's up, guys? How are you guys? You guys having fun?
Dude.
At one point they clapped, the whole Congress like clapped for like a veteran or something. Mm-hmm. And he was like, they wouldn't do that for me. Like, he was just winging it. That was, I mean, again, I don't want to sound too pro-Trump, but that was a good speech. He did great.
But he did good.
I thought he did good.
Dude.
But I mean, it was standard fucking like a lot of dumb. I mean, there was this fucking female, like a girl cancer survivor. Sure. The way they do it to explain each policy, they bring in somebody.
Yeah.
Like they brought in a family who their grandparents got murdered by MS-13.
Stop,
and
dude.
And Congress clapped for them. MS-13 killed like 2 80-year-olds.
Did they
in
really?
Their house. Yeah, it was fucking hilarious.
Do you think 6ix9ine had any connection with it?
Tekashi?
He snitched, dude.
For sure.
He snitched.
He's been snitching.
You know
dude,
that.
Think about MS-13 breaking into your nan and pap's house. And icing them, dude. What
I mean,
a sick way to go.
Imagine though, watching
how hyped
Fox
your grandpa
News
was.
Your whole life, and your little fucking granddaughter's like, "Grandpa, turn this shit off, isn't it that night?" And all of a sudden, MS-13 breaks in and murders you, dude. That guy must have been like, "Yes, yes,
dude,
yes."
What a fucking that guy for 5 minutes while they were breaking in, he was Clint Eastwood.
Oh,
he
dude.
Was finally an old white man just like, not my house, not my country, you dirty sons of bitches. And then he got murdered. But yeah.
He was definitely like, hey guys, what?
But that's how I want to die. I
hope
I'm
MS-13.
80. I hope I'm 80 years old. Me and my bitch are just watching TV again.
Definitely.
A bunch of fucking cholos break in and ice
that's
us.
A good,
dude.
That's an honorable death,
just to
dude.
Steal like our plates or whatever valuables they had.
I wonder what they. A lot of geezers aren't really like. A lot of times, a little bit of cash squirrels.
Yeah,
the guy could have been the juice man, dude.
You think he was the
he
juice?
He might have been selling pills, dude.
Oh yeah, they probably got some pills.
Dude,
out of
old
those
people
geezers.
Have so many fucking pills, dude.
Yeah, those MS-13 made out like bandits that night.
That guy might have been Poppy.
You think
he might have been the plug?
You think that geezer was the plug?
He might have been the plug, dude. They might have stormed the plug.
That's probably, I mean, they don't just ice random geezers.
That's what I'm saying.
That was a fucking plug.
Well, that's what they do, Shane.
Just ice
random geezers. Come in here and they rape and kill old people. They're real big.
I mean, that was his message. He was like, this is what happened to these old people. They get raped and murdered by a couple Mexicans.
Like, actually,
it's fucking nuts.
Oh, my God.
At one point, he was talking about Venezuela, and he was like, used to be a beautiful country. Socialism has ruined it. And he's like, I want everyone here to make the pledge. We will never be a socialist country. And of course, the Republicans stand up and clap. And then
the
camera just zooms in on Bernie Sanders, who's sitting there like Trump out of nowhere in the middle of speech was just like, we're not communists. We'll never be communists. Next topic. We're going to the moon. Next topic. It was fucking wild.
That's awesome. We're going back to the moon.
Yeah,
dude.
He had Buzz Aldrin up in the rafters. He was like, yo, shout
Aldrin
out,
loves
Buzz.
Him, dude.
Aldrin's out of his fucking gourd, dude. He was wearing like a mini American tie. It came up to like his nipples. he stood up and was like, he saluted him with these bug eyes.
Oh my God.
You gotta watch it.
I'm going to check
that
out.
Watch the State of the Union. Get high and watch that tonight.
For sure.
You're going to be like,
it'll be
holy
fantastic.
Shit, this is chaos.
The last thing I saw was Pelosi and Schumer talking to Trump, and I was like, I checked
Pelosi
out.
Pelosi and Schumer's post-Trump, their rebuttal was one of the gayest fucking things
they
ever
said.
What did they say? Was that was the night, the one you're talking about, where they both stood at the podium together.
I was talking about when they went into his office like months ago, and they were like, no, you shut the government down first. Like, well, yeah. I did it, but like not as long as you shut the government. It was like... It's a bunch of fucking old people losing their minds. What the fuck?
They do the other party has a response after the
State of the Union. State of the Boonian, dude.
Yeah, dude.
We're like, yeah, did you hear that? Trump said we're going to...
The Democrats had a power move, dude. They had a black lady, fat black lady, standing at a podium.
Fuck.
All women of different races behind her on like a bleachers.
Oh, fuck.
And she stood there and was like, my dad worked at a factory. My mom was a librarian. America is great. Like, it was just like...
I mean, it's the same thing as bringing up to fucking
the
grandchildren of an MS-13 murdered. Dude, stuff that's not a new conclusion, but like, to watch people watch the same thing and have two very different reactions to it is fucking nuts.
I mean, yes, if somebody watched the State of the Union and was like, Trump's a fucking loser and this is crazy, I'd be like, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
But I watched it, I was like, Trump daddy, dude. Yeah, I mean, jokingly, I was like, he fucking killed it.
It's crazy that people will watch, like, you're watching it, you're like, all right, Trump's fucking bringing up vets. You're seeing
tricks
that are being played.
Easily.
And for someone to watch it and be like, I can't believe you brought them up. And they're like, watching the other lady, like, nothing to see here.
Right.
Yeah,
it's
fucking nuts, dude. Exactly.
The totally diverse bleacher of women behind this black lady giving a speech.
Hand-selected, dude.
Oh, right. Absolutely. They hand-select them at fucking comedy specials.
Yeah, man.
That's weird.
It's weird as fuck.
You ever see that?
I assumed that.
They do that.
Yeah.
When you get to a comedy special taping, they decide who sits in the front row. Like, while people are walking in, they'll look at the audience and be like, all right, you two, come up here. And it'll be like a biracial couple.
Right.
Perfect.
And they'll be like, you, black chicks, get up front. Like, it's wild.
Yeah, they want to see it like that diverse reaction and stuff.
Yeah.
That's
funny.
Pretty crazy.
Watch, go to HBO when you get a chance and watch Amanda Seals. Fuck, I don't think that's her name. I forget who it is.
Amanda Bynes?
No, it might. It's Amanda Bynes. Fuck, I shouldn't be just trashing someone now that I'm in the
just
in the industry.
You're talking about the production.
But no, just go watch it. I think it's Amanda Seals.
Yeah.
You're not trashing her. You're
and she's
trashing
like,
the
well, now you're trashing her.
Yeah, fuck it. At the beginning of the special.
You were.
Yeah. If I met her, I'd be like, yeah, it's nice to meet you. But,
I love you.
At the beginning of the special, she's walking through, like, on her cell phone, walking up to the stage. She's like, this special is not for homophobes. No. This ain't for racists. This ain't for Trump fans. This ain't for, like, she just names all these things.
Yeah.
She's like, this ain't for fuckboys. This ain't, it's just like.
Man, that sucks.
So while I was watching that, I was like, all right, I'm out.
Yeah.
I guess Yeah.
Yeah, but you also, I mean, you were the one fish that went through a net. There was a villain that went in there, like, yay!
Yeah.
Which is like. I mean, dude, I don't think I'm this dumb, but it, like, I swear to God that you have to be kind of stupid for that to be like, fuck yeah.
Oh, of course.
It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, you have to. There's.
It's not even about the position. It's
exactly
it's the
what
tactic.
You were just saying.
It's the tactic
to
that
fall
I see.
For
like,
any of these tactics, you have to be a fucking. You have to be dumb.
Fucking sucks.
Like, you can listen to like I listened to like what a lot of Bernie Sanders shit, what he was saying, and I was like, nice.
Yeah.
But then once they got into the tactics of it, it was like, oh, this sucks now.
Yep.
This is fucking corny.
I'm stoked on all that stuff, dude. Free college. My thing with the free college, everyone bugs out about that. They're like, the taxes are high. But it's like, dude, if you're coming out and you're paying your regular taxes plus student loans plus healthcare, it's like getting taxed fucking 60% anyway. You're just paying it rather than being taxed.
And if you're poor, which most people are out of college, the interest, like I can't even make a dent into my student loans. At this point, when I had a job that paid well, when I was selling cars, I was putting like $1,000 a month into my student loans so I could just bang it out. And then once I stopped paying it, it's like I never paid anything.
Right. Yeah, it's great. It's usury. It's fucking ridiculous. It's usury. It's insane.
Yeah.
It's insane.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm all about that. But, you know, I also don't really give a fuck. Like I think I'm off of health. I think my health care is going to lapse.
Nice.
I don't really give a shit. But that people all the time like 60% tax is crazy. It's like, dude, you're spending 60% on shit anyway. You could add free college.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all about that. It's going to become free though, because it's like the cost of it's half of it can be done online. It's gonna, the price has to go down. It's fucking insane how much it is.
Right.
It's like if you could come out with like 100 G's.
Which is surprising because aren't most college professors like super fucking communist, super liberal? Left-ro.
Yeah.
And now it's like, how much money are you making?
Oh,
how much money are you making and how much am I paying?
I Google.
To hear you espouse this exactly, communist
dude.
Shit.
All the people I read, there's like Francis Fox Piven, all these people who are like super leftist, like social science intellectuals. I started Googling them because, you know, they all this communism, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, all right. And I was like, let's see what they're up to. NYU professor makes about $250,000, $300,000 a year. It's like, you what the fuck?
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know what you're doing with your money, but it's like,
dude, that was
that's
like,
kind of crazy. Like,
I remember when I Googled fucking Rage Against the Machines Network. It's like, oh, what the fuck?
Yeah, I'm for all that, but that's crazy. Yeah, it's just insane to be like, I'm making money being a socialist in a capitalist system. I'm making money off being espousing socialist ideas in a capitalist enterprise.
Wow.
It's fucking nuts, dude.
It's a little wacky.
A little suspect.
That's why we need Trump Daddy in 2020. If you listen to this podcast, you have to swear an oath right now to vote for Donald Trump, dude.
You got to write in the secret podcast.
Yeah, true.
That we need Washington to know about us.
Yeah.
Write us in, dude.
Oh, March.
What you got?
14th?
What?
Live cast, dude. It's not set. That. Not set in stone.
Yeah.
But we're floating it out. March 14th or whatever that Thursday is. I think it's a 13th or a 14th.
Yeah. Where are you guys doing it?
At Helium Comedy Club in Philly.
Yep.
Live podcast March 14th.
Shit, yeah.
And then there was rumblings of a possible Buffalo Helium live cast. And I don't know how, I don't know what we would sell up there.
Yeah.
So if you're up there, let us know.
Yeah.
Because I said, I don't think.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah. But anyway, March 14th.
Sorry to get this fucking cat out of his fucking house, dude.
What's that?
It's hard to get this cat.
I know. And as soon as they were like, do you guys want to come up to Buffalo? No. I was like, it's going to be tough to get Matt up there.
Oh, dude, that thing you're talking about with colleges, though, there's a... So apparently back in the 50s, I'm going to say, somewhere around this time, there was like... It was always kind of... College campuses were usually like left... Well, actually, it was a lot of right-leaning. And then like in the 50s and 60s, it went to like 3-1 liberal professors to one conservative type professor. And apparently if there's like there's a ratio where it's like, I think it might be like 8-1 or something, where if you have at least one of one party to 8 of the other party in some sort of institution, the whole thing won't become like radicalized, where there's like a little bit of a counterweight. But I think now in school it's like fucking like 37-1 or like 40-1 in colleges.
Oh, wow.
To where it's like liberal professors versus conservative professors. So that these places have like completely gone off the fucking rails.
Yeah.
Which is, and dude, my school has totally 100%. It's like you go in there, you're supposed to think a certain way. If you don't, you get like people react negatively to you. And it's like, it's fucking nuts.
It's crazy.
And I'm old enough to know like, all right, there's like a context here. If I was 18, throw me in here, I'd be like, fuck it. What do you guys want me to say? All
right. Yeah.
Right.
I'm like, if I was like in there like trying to get pussy and shit, and I was like, I would have totally been like, oh yeah.
Dude, we were lucky. When we were in school, just loose change was...
True.
That was out. And I was like, all right, I believe that. I'm loose change. If I was in school when they were like communism, I'd be like, fuck yeah.
Yeah, of course.
I'd love it.
Yeah. Dude, I would have, I'm telling you, like if I was in college and that was what was going on, and I'm in class and there's like some girl looks at me bad after, I'm like, well, I don't know. I don't think it's that bad. I would have been like, okay, yep. Instantly switch it up.
You know what we could do?
What?
We could cut it right now and finish the rest of this on Patreon.
Yeah, let's do that.
All right, so... Thanks to everybody that listened to this.
Yeah.
And the rest of this, we're going to keep talking with Gerbs. We're going to get into Gerbs' sexuality.
We haven't talked about Gerbs coming.
Yeah, we got a lot of cum questions for Gerbin. That'll be up on the Patreon. So
true.
God bless you all. February 16th, this coming Saturday, I'll be at Laugh It Up, Poughkeepsie. Mm. Ocani's featuring. It'll be good.
That'll be nice.
Yeah. March 14th, possibly live cast at Helium.
Damn.
8 p.m. on a Thursday.
Should sell out.
Club going off, dude.
Fuck yeah.
All right.
Bye, y'all.
This will finish.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back with the less pull. Shit I smoke is like cholesterol. Spilled dressing on the vest at the festival. The best of all. Had a midget Puerto Rican at my